Let's wait for some people to join. I'm just wondering if viewers show up if they don't use the web interface, like if you just pull the stream with MPV, for example. Oh, there are some viewers. Okay, well, that means we can get started. I just want to highlight that Descent 1 and 2 that I showed yesterday and Free Space 2 are on sale on GOG.com this weekend. And here's Free Space 2 for $3.39. You can download it and then use the FS2 open port to play it. Note that this port does not have a real license coming with it. It doesn't say that you can't use it, but it doesn't really allow free distribution explicitly, so that's why you have to build it on your own. It's not illegal, it's a Free Space 2 open source project, it's just the license is not a real license. So for those who've never done it, you can visit the FAQ, Building a System from Source, to find out how to get the ports tree. Here, start with the Avoiding Root Privileges section. You may have to log back into X11 after you do that, or just reboot. That's what I usually do when I install a new system, and then you can fetch either the stable tree or the current tree, but you want to not go to user source, but rather ports. Like you go to user and then you do checkout -P ports to get a ports tree, and then you build it yourself doing something like this. I've already built it. You do this, you go to games, FS2 open, and then you just do make install, and it then compiles the whole port for you and installs it, and then you should be good to go. So there's a launcher that we don't have in the ports tree at this point, so I just want to highlight what you may want to use here as the command line parameters. That's no parse errors, because otherwise it's going to throw a bug when when opening the like one of the message or content files, and that bug doesn't stop it if you continue just clicking on debug, but it may close out your full screen window, and the game runs anyway. It's a little confusing, but it's much easier to handle if you just pass no parse errors on the command line. I'm also running it windowed in 1280 by 720 just to help with the stream. So let's see what's happening here. Oh, 6 viewers. So, disclaimer, I haven't really played this game much. I may totally fail today, but if you enjoy seeing me fail in space, then you're gonna have a blast. With this said, let's get started. I'll let the intro play for you guys for a little bit of background, at least part of it. It's several minutes long, but I've tweaked the settings a little bit before starting the game, so I'm confident now after testing that the sound should be okay and the volumes should match, so that you can still hear me even when the game's getting a little louder. For those who don't know the game, it's a space dogfighting game or space simulator in the vein of the Wing Commander series, as opposed to Privateer. Privateer is more the free roaming, trading the galaxy, while Wing Commander and Free Space are more action-oriented, following series of mid-branching missions. These are some of the fighters. I think this is recapitulating what happens in Free Space 1. Great War, I think, was the main species. I haven't really played it. Another disclaimer about this port, some of the audio samples have some slight stuttering in their playback. I don't know why, I don't know how to fix it at this point. It doesn't make the game unplayable, it's still very enjoyable, but you can notice it. It's in the mission previews. And it's not part of the recording, it's the state of the recording. Well, yeah, this is that fight. It's getting a little bit. So let's skip this. I've already created a pilot here, and I've gone through the training missions, so to spare you that, because they're a little slow, the training missions. Here's a user tip. Before you start, you can go to settings here. There's a whole bunch of settings. There's a multiplayer, which I've never tried, honestly. But here you can set the graphic settings. And here, mouse off, focus sensitive, skill level. Let's leave it easy. I'm not going to do any crazy difficulty settings today. I'm bad enough at this game as it is. As far as here you can configure the controls. here's the mission room. Note that there is a bunch of mods. I can start like Babylon 5. There's FS Port for Free Space 1. There's Wing Commander mod, all running in the engine of this port. So, this said, start. You'll notice the slight sound stuttering now as we get the moving.
This is Admiral Petrov, commanding officer of the GGD Aquitaine. Those squadrons joining us here in Vega, welcome aboard. With a complement of 150 combat spacecraft, the Aquitaine serves as flagship of the GTVA Third Fleet, based in the Capella system. You join an elite crew of 10,000, the finest officers and enlisted personnel serving the Alliance today. After 18 months of fighting Admiral Bosch's Neo-Terran front, it's become the most significant threat to regional security since the Great War ended 32 years ago. The NTF demands the independence of their systems and the revocation of the Beta Aquilae Convention, or BATAC. The BATAC Treaty centralized power of the GTVA as the supreme authority in Terran Vasutan space. Integral to NTF ideology is Bosch's vision of Neo-Terra. The utopian society, with the lost grandeur of Earth, will be restored. Bosch and his followers oppose any alliance with the Vasutans as a threat to the future of the human race. The rebels are entrenched in Polaris, Regulus, and Sirius. But before we hit these strongholds, we must...
Let's skip ahead a little bit.
Allied Command has ordered the Aquitaine to the Tenev system. There, we will reinforce the 13th Vasutan battle group led by the GVD Santa.
Don't ask me about the
both
lore of the game.
The NTF and the GTVA have sustained heavy casualties in the battle for Deneb. In the past 72 hours, we have lost the GBC Andromeda, GTC Trafalgar, and over 15 fighter wings. Command anticipates the arrival of the Aquitaine and the Zaptic will shift the battle for Deneb in our favor and force the NTF to withdraw to Sirius.
Okay, so that's it. We can get help here, or go back to the options, but in this case, we're just going to continue. And that's not a real
thing. This is Captain Lukaka, Squadronator of the 53rd Hammerheads. At 0320 hours, the Aquitaine entered the Deneb system. Admiral Petrarch launched fighter and bomber wings as part of an all-out attack against NTF positions throughout the system. He has kept the Hammerheads on standby until now.
Okay, we're the Hammerheads, I guess.
A situation is developing near the inhabited planet of Cygnus Prime. We have over 100,000 Vasutan refugees fleeing their colonies in transports. Allied ships are rescuing the Vasutans as quickly as possible, though the logistics of this operation leave many refugees still vulnerable to rebel attack. At 0545, we received a distress signal from a refugee convoy 900 clicks, or kilometers, from the outer orbit of Cygnus Prime. The Vasutans responded with a wing of Serapis fighters, designated Epsilon, which have just called...
Be back in a moment, just want to not miss anything in the chat.
Hold in for reinforcements. Alpha Wing, you're going in. Because these transports do not have jump drives, you must protect the convoy until a recovery ship arrives. With all warships engaged and other convoys in dire need of protection, we do not know when a craft will become available. Command will keep you updated and send in reinforcements as needed.
Okay, protect the IOTA until your relief is due. Okay.
Alpha 2 here. I have a visual on the convoy. 1,500 meters dead ahead. The escort wing is down two fighters. IOTA transports, this is Alpha Wing of the 53rd Hammerheads, GTD Aquitaine. We have orders to protect your convoy. What's your status? Over.
Alpha Wing, we have lost three transports to the rebel attack. The surviving vessels have sustained moderate damage. We anticipate the rebels will return in greater force.
Okay, hang in there, IOTA. Command will send recovery craft as soon as possible. Alright, Alpha. Let's get to work. We must defend these transports until a recovery ship arrives.
The percentage of hull, I think, of the ships that we're escorting.
Sensors picking up incoming hostiles.
Okay.
A wing of Hercs closing in. Alpha 1 and 2, intercept those fighters. We will defend the transports.
Dots on the side mean that others are attacking the enemy. Quite a bit away from the enemy. Okay, my buddy took care of that. There's a communication system. I'm trying to not make things too complicated yet. It's afterburner. There's the fuel on the left side.
Subspace. We have vectored its course to your immediate vicinity. The rebels are retreating. They broke off their attack.
Acknowledged, Command. We will intercept the target.
Okay.
Incoming jump signature. It's the Belisarius.
That's a larger ship.
Gunnery control. Power up photon beam cannons. Commence plasma core insertion.
All units stand clear of the Samtic and Belisarius.
Belisarius, this is the GVD Samtic. You are ordered to power down and surrender.
Okay, I think you can see
negative,
some of the bigger ships in action.
The NTF is the only legitimate authority in this system. Surrender or be destroyed, Belisarius. This is your final warning. Your posturing insults us both, Basutin. I will not give up my ship. As you wish. Gunnery control, open fire.
Okay.
Belisarius' objective has been neutralized.
One of the bigger ships. Just being taken out.
Now deploying Wing Zeta and Theta. You are relieved of your escort, Alpha Wing.
Okay.
Mission accomplished, Alpha. Return to base. Well done, pilots.
this.
Good work, pilot. You held off the rebel attack and saved both pursuit and transports from destruction. Your squad mates and I all agree you'll make a fine addition to the 53rd Hammerheads. Command reports that 75% of the refugees have been recovered with few casualties. The remaining 25% are under Allied protection and will be rescued shortly. We've also won major victories against the NTF. The NTD Jacobus and the NTC Hengst have been destroyed, and our blockades of the Alpha Centauri and Sirius jump node has isolated the rebel fleet. Furthermore, 600,000 ground troops will soon land on the surface of Cygnus Prime in our effort to retake the planet. Prepare for your next mission, pilot. The battle for Deneb is not over yet.
Okay, let's look at some stats. Okay, skill level easy. Total pulse 2. Power hit percent 37%. Secondary 75%.
Has ordered the 53rd Hammerheads to secure an NTF depot in the Deneb asteroid belt. Six sentry guns are positioned around the depot, and rebel freighters are now moving the cargo out of the area. The NTF has gone through a lot of trouble to hide these materials. Alpha 1, your mission is to seek and destroy all targets of opportunity, including freighters, cargo, and sentry guns. Beta Wing will scan the cargo. Recon sighted a wing of Loki's guarding the depot, so prioritize these bandits. Do not underestimate the importance of this mission, pilot. A depot raid won't win you any medals, but it can be just as vital as taking down a cruiser or a corvette. We must sever rebel supply lines if we want to achieve a decisive victory.
Yeah, they do that early on in these games. They have you just...
Okay, Alpha Wing, let's take out the fighters and freighters. Beta will scan the cargo. Watch those sentry guns. Beta Wing, target cargo units and close in to scan. Optimal distance is 150 meters. Alpha 1 and Alpha 3, two target providers. Stay focused on those Lokis.
Command, we got a problem here. We can't scan the cargo.
Diagnostic beta. Are your sensors malfunctioning?
Negative. There's some kind of shielding on these units. Our sensors can't penetrate.
Acknowledge beta. Avoid the scan and engage the enemy.
What about a recovery app?
Negative beta. Command will not risk recovery in that asteroid belt.
Interference.
There should be a flashing red blip on the radar screen of your HUD. Maneuver your fighter until this blip is centered in the radar. This will point you in the right direction.
It's a large asteroid, Command, with some kind of structure built into the surface.
Let's take a closer look. Proceed with caution, pilots.
Something exploding.
Command, the target has turrets and a fighter bay. It must be a rebel installation.
We're scrambling bomber wings now. Destroy that base, pilots.
Sign the death warrant of our race. I demand unfettered access to the Sirius jump node.
There will be no negotiations, Marsh.
Listen to me. If my safety is guaranteed, I'll withdraw my forces from the net.
Pilots, destroy that installation. You have your orders. Installation. Disable the engines of that warship. Do not let them escape.
I'm gonna disable the
engines.
There's
no time, Command. The vessel is powering up its subspace drive.
Okay. Okay. Well, there are probably a couple of bonus objectives that I didn't hit.
Command has issued no official explanation for Admiral Bosch's presence in the Denem system. The hidden base and the shielded cargo units only compound the mystery of the Admiral's agenda. Under the circumstances, there was nothing you could have done to stop the escape of Bosch's command frigate, designated the NTF Iceni.
Well, at least they're not mad at me for letting him get away.
Intelligence has tracked Admiral Bosch's command frigate, the NTF Iceni, through subspace. We have vectored its course to the Sirius jump node. The 53rd is being scrambled to seek and destroy the Iceni before it escapes Deneb. We have pre-assigned your loadout, and your fighters are now standing by. Report to the flight deck pronto.
Full burners and intercept the ICD. They are 2 kilometers from the Sirius jump node.
Command, we're 5 clicks from that Corvette. Those coordinates you gave us were bogus. We don't stand a chance of catching that ship.
You have your orders, pilot.
Command, where's the blockade? Why isn't the Alliance guarding this node?
Our line of defense has been reprioritized for engagements elsewhere in the system.
I think there's no way that we can stop this one from. Leaving the system. The mission's bound to fail if I remember this correctly.
I regret your efforts to intercept us have failed, pilots. But be well advised to question the wisdom of your leaders. Helm, engage subspace drive.
The Iceni has jumped! I repeat, the Iceni has jumped!
Acknowledged, pilot.
Request a status brief, Command. What the hell is going on here?
You're out of line, pilot.
Out of line? I don't think so. We're risking our lives out here. We deserve a straight answer.
You can discuss this at your debriefing. We now have reports that Rebel vessels are heading for the jump node. Stand by for mission update. Command out.
Damn it! Command let Bosch escape.
What are you talking about?
They pulled the blockade. They gave us the wrong coordinates. There's no other explanation.
Why would they let him go?
You tell me, pilot. I'm informed on a need-to-know basis.
Stand down. We're on your side here.
Why did we attack the Iceni? Why did we destroy that cargo? I can live with being a pawn if the game makes sense.
Inbound freighters with Loki escort. These targets escape the asteroid depot. Destroy those ships before they reach the node.
Beta Wing here. Target acquired and closing in.
Okay, primary objectives complete. Except for destroying the Orsini.
Two NTF cruisers have jumped in. The NTC Glorious and the NTC Impervious. They are heading for the node. Eliminate the fighter escort pilots. We'll deploy the SAMTIC to handle the cruisers. Those cruisers have anti-fighter beams with an effective range of 1,500 meters. Lure the escort away from the cruisers before you engage.
Serious jump node. I have received no explanation either on or off the record for what happened out there. I assume we'll be informed on a need-to-know basis. Good job neutralizing those fighters and freighters. You've served the 53rd Hammerheads well. Your performance in this last mission proves you have what it takes to be an ace pilot. I've recommended your transfer to the 107th Ravens. They lost many good officers in Deneb, and they could use someone with your talents. They're the top-notch unit. I know you'll make us proud. Good luck with your new assignment, pilot. Has ordered the Aquitaine to return to the Capella system. Admiral Petrarch will address the crew at 0630.
Let's look at the stats. those two?
Welcome to the 107th Ravens, pilot. I'm Lieutenant Samsa, squadron leader. As you know, the Aquitaine is now en route to the Gamma Draconis system. The details of the situation there have been classified at the highest level, so I'm as much in the dark as you are. The Admiral will brief the crew when we reach 3rd Fleet Headquarters in Capella. The 107th is a heavy assault squadron, so our fighter of choice is the Hercules Mark II. Implementing advances in fusion drive technology, the Mark II improves the assault fighter's speed and maneuverability without sacrificing loadout. The Herc has only 2 missile banks, but its ordnance capacity is greater than the Myrmidons. The original Herc won the Great War, so we're proud to carry on the tradition.
Mm-hmm.
I recommend that you review the Herc II training modules before the Aquitaine arrives in Capella. These modules review advanced tactics, such as countermeasures and energy management. The Herc II is slower than the Myrmidon you've been flying with the 53rd, so learn how to evade missiles and equalize shields. These skills will help you push your fighter to the limits. Master them, and the life you save may be your own.
Okay, I guess that's some more tutorial missions. We can do one or two of them.
According to your file, you are now authorized to use the GTW-58 Prometheus R, the GTM-19 Harpoon, and the GTM-4 Hornet missile.
Mm-hmm.
The Prometheus R is a retrofit of a cannon developed during the Great War. After the Alliance lost contact with Earth, we lacked materials required for mass production, so engineers developed this retrofit version. The Prometheus packs a bigger wallet than the Subang HL-7, but it will drain your power reserves with extended use.
I'm honestly not really keeping track of all the weapons, so too confusing.
While the Harpoon fires individual warheads, the Hornet launches a swarm of 4 projectiles, 8 if you're in double fire mode. The training modules cover the proper technique for firing aspect-seeking missiles, so be sure to review that section carefully. That's all for now, pilot. The Aquitaine will arrive in Capella in 4 hours.
Simulator Module DSM-107M. Advanced qualification for the Hercules Mark II Heavy Assault Fighter. This module has been designed to acquaint pilots with communication systems, countermeasures, and aspect-seeking missiles. DSM units are approved for use as part of the GTVA Combat Training Program, or as a review for qualified pilots. The DSM series is not intended as a substitute for actual field training.
Sure.
Welcome to module DSM-107M, pilot. Don't touch the controls until you are told to do so. You will fail this session if you do not follow instructions carefully.
These tutorial ones
Let's
are
begin
real
with messaging.
Boring.
For
Sorry.
Class A qualification, you learned how to call in a support ship to rearm and repair subsystems. Now, we'll show you how to give orders to pilots under your command.
Okay.
Our target for this simulation will be an Argo-class transport. Target the transport. Use your hostile targeting control. Good. Now you'll call in your reinforcements. Press the communications key to bring up the messaging window. Select reinforcements. Then, select the wing you want to call in. Epsilon wing is your only option, so hit the 1 key.
Okay, so we call in reinforcements. I think that leads to decreasing mission score.
Confirm that you still have the transport targeted. Now, have Epsilon wing destroy the transport. Press the communications key to bring up your messaging box again. Select 2 to transmit your orders to a specific wing. Then hit 1 to choose Epsilon Wing. By selecting Epsilon Wing, you are sending your orders to that wing only. Now, press the 1 key, and Epsilon will destroy you. Well done, pilot. Let's try this again. Order Epsilon Wing to destroy Transport 2. Do you remember your previous instruction? If not, consult the directives list. Reinforcements are not always available, and you will have authorization to issue orders only to specific wings and ships. Now, let's order Epsilon Wing to depart. Press the communications key to bring up the messaging window. Select 2 for Wing and 1 for Epsilon. Finally, press 0 for depart.
Bye-bye, Epsilon.
Excellent work. As you gain experience in combat, using the communications interface will become second nature.
Yeah, right.
All right, pilot. Now it's time to learn about countermeasures. When you launch a countermeasure, you present a new target for pursuing missiles. In theory, the missiles should hit the countermeasure instead of ripping a hole through your hull.
Okay.
You need to use countermeasures to survive in battle, but you'll soon learn this tactic does not always work. For this exercise, we'll bring in a Leviathan-class cruiser. The cruiser will now launch missiles at you. Press the countermeasures key to evade the missiles. Immediately increase your forward velocity to maximum and move away from the pursuing missiles. Punch your afterburners to gain that extra burst of speed. A yellow triangle will appear on your HUD, indicating the vector of the missile's approach. Try to keep this indicator in the 3 or 9 o'clock position. When the missile is nearly upon you, launch the countermeasure. Listen to the beeping sound of the missile lock to gauge the distance of the missile. The quicker the beeps, the closer the missile. While launching countermeasures, turn your fighter hard in sharp movements. This will also help throw the missile off your trail. If you evade the missile, an indicator will display in the upper portion of your targeting reticle. This will alert you to the fact that you successfully avoided the projectile. The number of countermeasures remaining is indicated on your HUD below the weapons display. If you run out of countermeasures, call in the support ship to reload. That's enough for evading missiles. Now, let's practice firing them. Your Hercules Mark II heavy assault fighter is armed with 2 banks of harpoons. Unlike heat seekers like the Rock Eye, you must acquire a lock on your target in order for an aspect seeker to home. However, the aspect seeker is well worth the effort because its homing ability is much stronger. If a heat seeker loses track of its target, chances are it will not reacquire lock. Aspect seekers, on the other hand, will track their targets until they detonate. Transport 3 is now entering. Let's take this opportunity to learn another targeting control. You have a reticle targeting control that will acquire the nearest object inside your reticle. Maneuver your fighter so that my ship is centered on your HUD. Good. Now use the reticle targeting control to target my fighter. Well done. Now, target transport 3 using the reticle targeting control. Make sure the transport is in the center of your HUD. Excellent. Now, let's see how you do with those harpoons. Notice the red indicator moving towards your target. That's the aspect triangle. Once it is moved onto your target, you'll see the lock indicator. This means your harpoons are locked and ready to fire. Now, fire one harpoon at the freighter.
Can you give it to me?
Note how fast the harpoon moves. This warhead delivers quite a punch. A round of harpoons can be fired every 3 seconds. Fire another round and note the countdown timer in your weapons gauge. The harpoon is almost useless if fired before lock has been acquired. That's a major distinction between the harpoon and the rock eye. Now, unload your harpoons until you've destroyed Transport 3. Excellent job. Let's see how you do against moving targets. In order to gain aspect lock on a moving target, you must keep the target's lock box in a fixed position inside your HUD reticle. We'll now bring in the fighter drones. When the first drone enters, target it and acquire lock. Try to keep the target indicator in the center of your HUD reticle. Once you have acquired lock, fire a harpoon to destroy the drone. These drones will not be using countermeasures. Well done. All aspect seekers function this way, from the Hornet missile to the Helios torpedo. In general, the larger and more powerful the warhead, the longer it will take to acquire lock and countdown between volleys. Now, let's have you face a real challenge. Multiple wings will appear simultaneously. Destroy them all. Must be in range of your target before you can gain aspect lock. Hit your burners to intercept the drone. SM-107M. Engage your subspace drive to end this simulation.
Okay.
Well done, pilot. You have successfully completed TSM-107M advanced qualification for the Hercules Mark II Heavy Assault Fighter. You are advised to proceed to training simulator.
It's another training module, but I'd say this is the
functioning shield management. Stop the recording. Transfer system.
Statistics don't really matter in these training missions anyway. Okay. Well,
welcome.
Thanks for watching.